Alhamdulillah Rabbil Alameen wa salatu wa salamu ala ashrafil mursaleen Sayyidina wa Nabiyyina Muhammadin wa ala alihi wa sahbihi ajma'in As-salatu wa salamu alayka ya Sayyidi ya Rasulullah ya Rahmatan lil Alameen ya Shafi'al Mudnibin Viewers, wherever you are around the world, Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Today, this evening, inshallah, whatever will come on the heart, I will try to explain. I need what I say, and you need what you say. If I say correct, it's good, you take it. If I say something else, forgive me. In Allah's eyes, we are all equal. In Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, love for everyone, we are all equal. An-nasu sawasiya. People are equal to each other, as Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said. An-nasu sawasiyatun ka asnan al-mishd. People are equal, like the teeth of the comb equal. All of them, they are perfect. If you have one up and one down, you cannot comb your hair. It might hurt you. They must be all equal in order that the comb is easy to comb your hair or your beard. But if it was not equal, you might have a wound or a pain. So Prophet ﷺ wants to tell us that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala created a human being equal in everything. An-nasu sawasiyatun ka asnan al-mushd. People are equal like the teeth of the comb are equal. لا فرق بين عربي ولا أعجمي إلا بالتقوى. There is no difference between a believer and non-believer, between a Muslim Arab or non-Muslim or a Muslim non-Arab. All equal. So we must not try to say I know more than you, or you say you know more than me. All of us, we know whatever we know in the eyes of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, we are equal. For that reason, we have to be very careful in understanding our limits, red lines. You cannot cross the red lines. You cannot cross the red light. Without fiqh, without learning sharia, everyone might cross the red line without knowing. And since you are mature above 15 years of age, it will be considered against you. I'm not saying this in order to make everyone afraid, but because I love to see people, young ones especially, old ones are finished. But young ones, they have the time to learn Shari'atullah, to learn what Allah wants from us, what Allah ordered us to do and what Allah prohibited us to do, in order to achieve his rida, his satisfaction. One of the things that we must know is that there are too many signs nowadays appearing in the sky of, as we say, سَنُرِيهِمْ آيَاتِنَا فِي الْآفَاقِ. We are going to show them our signs in the horizon. Means even the horizon is far in your eyes, in Allah's eyes is near. سَنُرِيهِمْ آيَاتِنَا. We are going to show them our signs, what is going to happen in the future, in the horizon which is slowly we are approaching. That horizon is Armageddon. The horizon that is coming, that is slowly it's coming toward us, is the Armageddon. Is the day of destruction. Is the day of war. Is the day of everyone will be hiding himself or herself in order to be safe. And too many signs coming today that we are seeing in front of our eyes. Look what happened 3 weeks ago in Philippines. How many deaths there? They say 10,000, but at least 50,000. In 5 minutes. Look what is happening in Middle East. Look what's happening everywhere. And if awliyaullah are not holding it, it would have blown up this whole earth. So we are inside that hurricane. We are inside that tornado. We are inside that evil power that everyone is trying to avoid. So to avoid that is very simple. Don't be munafiq. Inshallah, we are not munafiqoon. We are not people who say something and do something else. Or say something against someone in his absence, and then in his presence we make say something different to make him happy. No. So that we have to eliminate from our life. If we want to survive, Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, "Alamatul munafiq thalath." The signs of a hypocrite, munafiq, are three. And let us see and analyze. Is these three things are within us or not? If they are not within us, alhamdulillah, we are out of it. If they are within us, then we have to try to purify or try to eliminate it from our lives. First is a haddatha kathab. As soon as he opens his mouth to speak, he lies. Lie is not accepted. The first sign means the major sign that when munafiq speaks, he lies. Means a lie is completely forbidden. قُلِ الْحَقِّ وَلَوْ عَلَى نَفْسِكِ. Say the truth even on yourself. If you do something wrong, say I did something wrong. You don't need to say in front of people. Say it between you and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Don't repeat it and say astaghfirullah. إذا حدث كذب. If he speaks, he lies. And Prophet was being asked, عليه أفضل الصلاة والسلام, يا رسول الله, هل المؤمن يسرق؟ Is the mu'min steal?
Steal?
Is the mu'min steal something? قال ربما. He said might be. Might be a mu'min, a Muslim, will go and steal money. Steal jewelry. Steal something. He said, might be. You don't know why. Prophet ﷺ said, Rubbama, might be, he will do it. And too many in history, there are too many people, they are stealing. Might be some people, they have a project to get it from somewhere, project, money. Someone else comes, try to steal it from him. And this happened a lot. This is signs of the last days. This is a sign of the tornado that we are in. This is the sign of the hurricane that we are in. This is the sign of the Armageddon that we are in it. Then they asked him, هل المؤمن أو هل المسلم يزني؟ هل المسلم يزني؟ Do a Muslim makes adultery? And Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم said, might be. Adultery is from the biggest sins that we are not allowed to do it. من الكبائر. It's not easy. May Allah forgive all of us. هل المؤمن هل المسلم يزني؟ قال ربما. Might be. Then he said, then they said, يا رسول الله, هل المؤمن يكذب؟ هل المسلم يكذب؟ Is the Muslim lies? Make lies? Lie to this one, or to that one, or to that one, or to that one, or to that one, to make fitna? Or to make a business for himself from lying, cheating, lying to everyone, taking their money? Happened that? It happens between the communities?
Yes.
It happens. What Prophet said? He said, أَمَّا هَذِهِ فَلَا. There's no way. Muslim cannot lie. If we consider ourselves Muslims, we must not lie in anything. Are we lying? This one is young, might be not lying yet. Are we lying?
Yes.
Why are you afraid? Are we lying?
Yes.
Still they are not admitting. Are we lying? Yes. Say astaghfirullah. Allah will forgive. We are lying. We are lying to whom? The most lie, the biggest lie. You might lie between two brothers, two people. We might lie between two sisters. But There is a big lie that we are lying against Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. What is that? Is that we said something in one time and we ignored it in another time, or we breached it in another time. We confirmed something and later we change it. When Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in the day of Alastu bi Rabbikum, in the day of promises, he asked us, all human beings, am I not your Lord? Alastu bi Rabbikum? Qalu bala. They said, yes, Ya Rabbi. When they said yes, in that ocean of knowledge, in that ocean of the souls together saying in one voice, yes, al-Muslimun, Muslims, they said, yes, Ya Rabbi, you are our Lord. Anta Rabbuna, wa nahnu ibaduk, and we are your servants. We all agreed. When you agree on something, what happened?
Contract.
A contract. In dunya, you cannot, even if you breach your contract, they sue you, put you in prison. What you think about breaching your contract with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? When we agreed, Ya Rabbi, you are our Lord, Anta Rabbuna wa nahnu ibaduk, means La ilaha illallah Muhammadur Rasulullah. Means Ashhadu an La ilaha illallah wa Ashhadu anna Muhammadur Rasulullah. I bear witness that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is our Creator and we are His servants. We came to dunya, we breached the contract. Because in the contract, when you say Ashhadu an la ilaha illallah wa ashhadu anna Muhammad Rasulullah, there is a contract of the five pillars of Islam. When you accept Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, you have to obey Him. Obedience is five pillars of Islam. Shahadatu an la ilaha illallah wa anna Muhammad Rasulullah. وإقام الصلاة وإيتاء الزكاة وصوم رمضان وحج البيت. How many Muslims are not fulfilling that requirement? Even Muslims who are praying, sometimes they don't fulfill that requirement. They don't pray on time. Or sometimes they pray one day, next day they don't pray. Or they pray one waqt, the other waqt they don't pray. It happened or not? So what happened then? You are breaching your contract. When you breach your contract, what happened? Punishment. So that's why we have to be very careful not to breach our contract with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And to not to breach is to learn Sharia. Then you will not lie. Because then you know what you are, the basis of Sharia, the structure, the foundation of your building. This building cannot be built without a foundation. If the foundation goes, this building will fall down. Allah gave us a structure, foundation, which are the five pillars. Then He gave us the building, which is Maqamul Iman, six pillars. آمنت بالله وملائكته وكتبه ورسله وباليوم الآخر وبالقدر خيره وشره. Then decoration of the building is مقام الإحسان. أن تعبد الله كأنك تراه فإن لم تكن تراه فإنه يراك. To worship Allah as if you are seeing Him. If you are not seeing Him, He is seeing you. So how you are going to lie to Allah who is seeing you? He is seeing us? Yes. He's seeing us. May Allah forgive us. Amen. Sayyida Aisha, Prophet, she was making dua, and Prophet said, Ya Aisha, ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that you will not be judged. Yeah. Because he said, من حسب عذب من حسب عذب. Anyone who will be judged by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, for sure he will be punished, because Allah will check everything, order angels to check everything. For sure they will find many things, like IRS, income tax. They check everything to find you guilty. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala then as a Muslim will forgive you, to show you His rahmah. But we must not take advantage from rahmatullah al-wasi'ah, Allah's greatest rahmah, mercy that is will manifest it on the Muslim in the Day of Judgment. So don't breach your contract. How do I don't breach my contract? Is by studying, knows the limits. When you go to get a driving license, what they ask you? Drive in front of inspector. You make one mistake, what happened? Finish. You cannot get your driving license. Because you might, what you say, trespass the limits. You might go over the limits. You might move on the red light. So you don't want that. You want your structure strong. So you have to learn your limits. And your limits cannot be known except through Sharia. Tariqa will give you the spiritual aspect of it. But Sharia will give you the foundation. You cannot build spirituality on no foundation. It will be like imaginary in the air. Something imaginary. Telling you what behind this wall, what's the benefit you? No, you want to know where is the wall in order not to hit your head. Unless if you like to hit your head, don't study Sharia, go hit your head. Armageddon is coming. Take you and go. You want to hit your head? Huh? No. Why you are not answering? You are like statues here. Do you want to hit your head? Uh-huh. So then we have to learn the limits. When there is a building, they are building a building, they put a yellow markers on the streets in order that you, if you go inside or you hit your head, you will be killed. Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, "Iza haddatha kadhib," if he speaks, he lies, the munafiq. So we have to know the limits where we cannot lie. It's dangerous. I'm not frightening you, but it's necessary sometimes to hear something that people, I am seeing around the world, I'm traveling, I am seeing young ones how they are trying their best to learn fiqh. Except our followers, Maulana's followers. I'm not seeing them moving in to study fiqh. Why? I don't know. There are many doctors I know. They take leave, like Dr. Azriman, but he doesn't take a leave. They take leave for 1 year and they go study crash courses in fiqh, in Islamic Sharia. To come back, at least he knows his Sharia. We don't see anyone here. It's not a mazra'a, a farm, it's a garden. Farm is, in a farm is dangerous to move, you don't know where there is a snake. But this group is a garden, but keep your garden protected by Sharia. إِذَا حَدَّثَ كَذَبْ وَإِذَا اَعْتُمِنَا خَانْ. If you trust him, this second sign of a hypocrite, munafiq, if you trust him, he betrays you. If you put some money with him, or say to him, keep this for me as amana, he will not give it to you back. What you do? You sue him. And then what happened to him? Go to jail. That is dunya law. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said in Holy Quran, إِنَّا عَرَضْنَا الْأَمَانَةَ عَلَى السَّمَاوَاتِ وَالْأَرْضِ وَالْجِبَالِ فَأَبَيْنَا أَنْ يَحْمِلْنَهَا وحملها الإنسان إنه كان ظلوما جهولا. We offered our trust, Allah is saying, we offered our trust to heavens, to paradise, heavens, and to earth, and to mountains, to carry it. فَأَبَيْنَا أَنْ يَحْمِلْنَهَا وَأَشْفَقْنَا مِنْهَا وَحَمَلَهَا الْإِنسَانِ إِنَّهُ كَانَ ظَلُومًا جَهُولًا. They refused, they said, Ya Rabbi, we cannot carry that trust, it's too much. وَأَشْفَقْنَا مِنْهَا, they ran away from it. We cannot carry that trust, it's heavy. Mountains cannot carry, heavens cannot carry, earth cannot carry. Who can carry? If heavens cannot carry, earth cannot carry, mountains cannot carry, human being with his ignorance, he said, I will take it, I will carry. فَحَمَلَهَا الْإِنسَانُ إِنَّهُ كَانَ ظَلُومًا جَهُولًا. Human being took it, and Allah said, he was oppressor and he was ignorant, he didn't know how to keep it safe. So إِذَا تُمِنَا خَان. He accepted the trust from Allah, but he betrayed Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Betrayed him because he didn't keep the trust clean. He didn't keep his prayer clean. He didn't keep his fasting clean. He didn't keep his sadaqah clean. He didn't keep his hajj clean. Blended it with too much sins here and there. So what's the benefit? He betrayed the trust. Did you betray the trust? Many times. All of us. So what Allah is saying, if you want to repent, I'm waiting for you. Repent. Say Astaghfirullah. When you want to travel 3 in the morning, do you put an alarm system to wake up? Okay. When Fajr comes, do you put an alarm to wake up? Not all of you. Why for traveling you put an alarm to catch the plane? When for prayer, which is more important, you don't put an alarm. Huh? Why? We have to understand why. What is inside us that anything for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, we delay it. Anything for ourselves, dunya, immediately we run after it. What there is magic? What kind of magic? It's not magic. It's a black magic from shaitan. Because there is a clot, small one in the heart of a human being where shaitan can enter and come out. Allah said, Prophet said. We have to be very careful. Why we are carrying a phone? Where is your phone? This is his phone. Is there in it alarm system?
Yes.
Do you put an alarm to say Astaghfirullah? Why? Every moment we go out on the streets or in the malls, we make sense. Our eyes make sense. Is not? Men and women. When you make sense, Allah, what he said? Say istighfar. So remind yourself, at least Allah gave you something to remind yourself. Put an alarm system every half an hour. It will ring and remind you to say Astaghfirullah. Might be you are in the middle of a sin and the telephone ring saying, say Astaghfirullah. Astaghfirullah. You'll be saved. It's not only for dunya, you can use it for akhira. وَإِذَا وَعَدَ أَخْلَفْ. The last sign of a hypocrite, the third one, if he promises, he does not fulfill his promise. If he promises, does not fulfill his promise. These are the signs of hypocrite. Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam was going from Medina toward one of these house of a sahabi far away, and on the road they stopped by a grave. And one of the Sahabis, companion of Prophet, said, Ya Rasulallah, I have something to do in that village. I go do it and come back. Prophet said, I will wait for you. He promised, I will wait for you. The Sahabi left. And Maghrib came. Zuhr came, Asr came, the man didn't come back. Maghrib came, didn't come back. Aisha came, didn't come back. They prayed, all of the prayers, and waiting, Prophet is waiting. Sahaba said, Ya Rasulallah, let's go. He said, no. Al-mu'minu is a wa'ada wafa. Mu'min, if he promised, he has to fulfill. I am waiting until he comes. He came next day. And Prophet was waiting. And didn't scold him. If it happened to us, what we do?
We will kill him.
Not we will kill him. We will leave him and we go back. Half an hour, 1 hour, he didn't come back, we go. Prophet waited. These are the signs that we are seeing today of Armageddon. Armageddon is moving with all its speed. The destruction of the world is coming. The major earthquake that's going to happen on earth is coming. You cannot say no. It's in Holy Quran. إِذَا زُلْزِلَتِ الْأَرْضُ زِلْزَالَهَا. When the earth will shake its big shake and everything open up. وَأَخْرَجَتِ الْأَرْضُ أَثْقَالَهَا. And the inside of the earth will come out. يَوْمَئِذٍ تُحَدِّثُ أَخْبَارَهَا. At that time, it will tell its story, what earth has seen from everyone lived on it, from men and women, from human beings, from animals, from trees, from insects, from birds, from fishes, from oceans, from mountains, from villages, from rivers, from everything is going to tell its history, its story to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, what everyone has done. Allahu Akbar. Say Astaghfirullah. That will not tell our stories. Ya Rabbi, we are asking forgiveness. Hide our stories.
Amen.
Or else, man husib, uzib, who will be judged, will be punished. That is coming. The, today they say tsunami is coming. Or the tsunami on Philippines is coming. Everyone has to run away. They did all their best to save people, but still thousands and thousands, tens of thousands died in Aceh. They say 250, but Yusuf Kala told me it's more than 500,000, and might be more. Syria now, it's from under their feet and from skies coming on them punishment, difficulties, killing hundreds of thousands. They say 100 now, 30, but at least 200 or 300. 2 million, 3 million refugees, 1 million and a half in Lebanon, 600,000 in Jordan, 600,000 in Turkey, and hundreds of thousands that they have run away with their passport are able to pass through different countries. The major one is coming. That is a sign. That is like epsilon compared to infinity. You know epsilon? Huh?
Yeah.
Epsilon compared to infinity means an atom lower, less than an atom compared to no beginning, something has no beginning, no end, big. What we are seeing is nothing. When what is coming, Grand Sheikh, may Allah bless his soul, he said,
Amen.
Grand Sheikh Sheikh Abdullah Daghestani said, Qaddas Allah surruh, people will be walking on dead bodies. A child of 7 years, his hair will become white. There will be no child of 7 years except his hair is white. They become older than their ages. This is coming. And we are not listening and taking care and be careful. Inshallah, we'll speak more on Friday evening in the Zawiya. Tomorrow I'm not available evening. We'll do in Zawiya, inshallah, on Friday. Anyone likes to come, you are most welcome. Wa min Allahi tawfiq. May Allah protect us.
Ameen.
From this big earthquake that coming on earth.
Ameen.
يَوْمَ تُبَدَّلُ الْأَرْضُ غَيْرَ الْأَرْضِ وَالسَّمَاوَاتُ غَيْرَ السَّمَاوَاتِ. When the earth will be changed to another earth. And Samawat means universe will be changed. A new earth will come. Allah is saying in Holy Quran, it's not us. يَوْمَ تُبَدَّلُ الْأَرْضُ غَيْرَ الْأَرْضِ. When the earth will be changed by another earth, that everyone will be finding himself in a new earth. Allah is not going to judge us on a dirty earth. Allah will judge His servants on a clean area, clean earth. Allah doesn't descend to judge His servant on something dirty. He will demolish this earth, create another earth, and bring everyone. May Allah forgive us.
Amen.
May Allah bless us. Bi hurmat al-Habib, hurmat al-Fatiha. We have to be very careful from that Armageddon. I put a book on Armageddon. It's not trying to promote it, but you cannot find it here. You might find it in Singapore. About on Armageddon, it was selling here in the country. On Armageddon, it's good to get it. It's Arabic English. So you can see where we are standing to these days. You can know, you can order it from Amazon if you cannot find it. May Allah forgive us. May Allah bless us. Bi hurmat al-Habib, bi hurmat al-Fatiha.